Hi everyone, I'm Mariana. Welcome to Create, Discover, Invest. In today's video, I'm gonna guide you through the process of minting an NFT on Rarible and also give you a few extra tips using information people are not usually aware of. Wanna learn the best way to mint your NFT on Rarible and save on gas fees? Stay tuned and let's get into the video. Okay, so the first thing we have to do is go to Rarible.com. If this is the first time you access their website, you'll be required to connect one of the supported wallets. Since I already connected my MetaMask wallet to Rarible before, all I have to do now, every time I access their website, is unlock MetaMask by inserting my password and the website will open. Now we have to click here on Create to start the process of creating our NFT. The first step to create our NFT is to choose between single and multiple collectibles. So basically, if we want to create a unique item, we have to choose single. While if we want to create multiple copies of an item, we should choose multiple. In this case, let's choose single to create a one-of-a-kind item. Here we have to upload the file. And as you can see, they support many formats like PNG, GIF, and MP3, for example. So let's choose the file here. Since I chose an MP3 file, I also have to upload a cover picture. We can now see the preview of the NFT here on the right. Now let's continue. The next step is to choose if we want to sell this NFT for a fixed price, if we are gonna auction off the item, or if we're gonna leave it open for bids. We're gonna sell this NFT for 0.003 ETH. But notice that there's a 2.5% fee. You could also change the currency by clicking on this icon. You can choose stable coins or multiple other tokens. But in this case, we're gonna leave it in ETH. Now here, we have the option to select unlock once purchased and insert a link or a digital key. At this point, it's very important to know that when you turn your artwork into an NFT, the file itself does not get stored in the blockchain. The entry in the blockchain consists of only a line of code containing metadata with a link that points to where a compressed version of the file is stored. This storage is provided by Rarible, so you don't have to worry about it. If the artist keeps the high-resolution version of the file stored on Google Drive, for example, he or she could simply insert the link to it in this field, and whoever buys the artwork would have access to the high-res file. I want the buyer of my NFT to have access to the uncompressed version of my work, so let's insert the link here. Instead of inserting the usual URL, we're gonna use the IPFS or Interplanetary File System, which is a protocol and peer-to-peer network for storing and sharing data in a distributed file system, and insert its unique address. The IPFS relies on cryptographic hashes. In this distributed file system, a hash is assigned to the file, and if you change the file, the hash will change as well. Every file added to the IPFS network is given a unique address based on its contents. This address is called a content identifier, or CID. And why am I doing this? Why is this important? Well, the content pointed to by the usual URL link could change or even go offline at any point in the future. If that happens, the original asset would be lost forever. The IPFS can help address this concern, and it gives more security for you and the collector. So to upload files on IPFS, I usually use Pinata, since I find it very easy to use. I already have an account on their website, so all I have to do is log in to see all the files I already uploaded on IPFS. To upload a new file, all we have to do is click on Upload and choose the file we want. The MP3 we're gonna turn into an NFT, in this case, is already here. So we can just right-click on the file, copy the link, and insert it on Rarible. By the way, we can also pin a file on IPFS using Pinata, once you have its CID. This can be very useful, especially for collectors, and provide extra security. Leave a comment in the comment section below if you want me to make a video only explaining IPFS for NFTs, also showing you how to get the CID of an item you collected and pin it for your own security. The next step is to choose a collection. Here we can either leave it on default or choose to create our own collection. The difference here is that by creating your own collection, you create your own contract with its own contract address on the Ethereum blockchain. You can think of collections as folders. By leaving on default, once you mint your artwork, it is going to be put on Rarible's public folder. If you create, in this case, an ERC-721 NFT, you are creating your own folder where no one but you can create NFTs. There are two main advantages for choosing this option. The first one is that it allows you to show your artwork as a collection and not as individual pieces. It also allows you to keep a certain style per collection. The second one is, let's say something happens to Rarible and the Rarible collection is difficult to access for whatever reason. Because the custom ERC contracts have their own addresses, they should be unharmed. The downside is that deploying smart contracts is more expensive than deploying in Rarible's default collection. In this case, we're gonna leave it on default and insert our file on Rarible's collection. Now here, we have to insert the title, so let's do that. We could also insert a description, but it's not mandatory. In my opinion, it's important to fill in the space to provide more clarity about your work to the potential buyer. So let's insert a description here. And for the royalty, we're gonna leave it at the default 10%. Note that you can choose whatever amount you want, but I suggest you leave it at 10% since it seems to be a standard in NFT marketplaces. By clicking on Advanced Settings, we have the option to insert a property and also a text describing our work for people with disabilities. Now, before we click on Create Item and start the minting process, let's first make sure we have the ability to change the gas price suggested by MetaMask. So we go to the MetaMask wallet and click on Settings, Advanced, and make sure that the advanced gas controls is turned on. It's very important to check the gas price before we mint our NFT, so we could change the price suggested by MetaMask and save some ETH, or even decide if that is the best moment to mint the NFT or not. To do that, I usually go to gasnow.org and check the price for fast, standard, and slow transactions. Bear in mind that these prices in dollars right here are for the usual transactions that use 21,000 gas units. Since minting an NFT demands more gas, it will be more expensive than what it's shown here, but it's still a good indicator. We can also check the average price per hour on each day of the week. So we could decide, based on historical data, when would be the best time to mint our NFT to save some money on gas fees. You could also download their Chrome extension and have easy access to gas prices in real time. Another option is to go to ethgas.watch, provide your email address here, and insert the gas price you are comfortable with. They will notify you once that price is reached. Now that we know what the gas price is, let's go back to the Rarible website and click on Create Item. If this is the first time you are interacting with Rarible, they're gonna ask you to confirm this interaction and you will have to pay gas fees. Since I've already been through this process, you won't be able to see it here. Now, in the MetaMask wallet, we'll be able to edit the gas price. So you could either choose the slow, average, or fast transaction process, or you could change the gas price here according to what the standard price is right now. I don't recommend choosing a price much lower than the standard price, since your transaction might take very long to complete, and that's if it ever does. Let's reject this transaction, since this NFT was already minted. So we're gonna click cancel and let's head to the profile page. Okay, so we are now on our profile and our NFT is here. You can also click on it to see it in more detail. If you mint your NFT on Rarible, you can also find it on OpenSea and sell it there as well. Alright everyone, that's all we have for today. Let me know in the comment section below if all the information in this video was helpful for you. Were you able to use the IPFS? Did my tips help you save some money on gas fees? I'm very curious to know. Thank you all very much for watching, and as always, I'll see you in the next video.